while Tesla is growing and building gigafactories as if nothing happened. The current pandemic shows that the legacy car makers are really fighting for their survival. In this video, we will argue why we think the lead of Tesla is going to increase even more and why most legacy car makers are already dead. Then we will of course also take a look at the current gigafactory progress. So Giga Berlin, but also Giga Shanghai.
And is Tulsa doomed?
Sorry, but that one had to be.
Will Austin get the Gigafactory after all?
And then something to laugh. The CEO of Audi says some quite hilarious, but also quite stupid stuff.
Then of course the Neuralink update this summer and possible legislation that might take Hyperloop mainstream in the US.
A lot to talk about as always, so stay tuned.
So if this pandemic has shown us anything, besides that humans are really not the smartest species in times of crisis, is that legacy automakers are really suffering a lot, with extreme drops in sales across the entire auto industry. We have declines of more than 30% for many legacy car makers, as we reported in last week's JI's disruption report. Video link in the description. But one company on this planet seems to defy this trend. Tesla is the single one company that completely defies the effects of this pandemic, with only 5% less car sales in Q2 2020 as compared to the same period in 2019. And Tesla is also the only company worldwide that sold more cars in Q2 2020 than in Q1 2020. And now that more news is surfacing on Tesla's Roadrunner project, which is basically the project with the goal of building the 1 million mile battery in-house at Tesla, we can see more and more clearly how insane the head start of Tesla really is as compared to the other car makers. You already know that Tesla acquired Maxwell Technologies a bit more than 1 year ago, which will have a dramatic impact on battery energy density. Maxwell's dry electrode fabrication process will allow for energy densities of around 300 watt-hours per kilogram in the near future. But Tesla has also quietly acquired C-Line, a startup from Colorado, which was working on new improved anodes and cathodes for lithium-ion batteries.
As Elon said, the term lithium-ion is actually misleading. He said, quote, "Although they're called lithium-ion, the actual percentage of lithium in a lithium-ion cell is approximately 2%. Technically, our cells should be called nickel graphite because the primary constituent in the cell as a whole is nickel. On the anode side, it's graphite with silicon oxide. So much for the there isn't enough lithium for all the lithium-ion batteries on Earth narrative. Now Elon indicated on Twitter that a nickel cathode and a carbon silicone anode would work even better, which coincidentally is exactly what C-Line has been working on. C-Line already built 2.5 ampere hour prototypes capable of achieving more than 300 watt hours per kilogram. Now combine this with Maxwell Technologies' dry electrode fabrication process and boom, we have the stuff for the big revelation at Tesla's Battery Day, currently scheduled for the 22nd of September. We think that Tesla is going to reveal a complete assembly line at Fremont for the next generation million mile battery, which will most likely offer an energy density of about 300 watt hours per kilogram, maybe even 350 watt hours per kilogram, with a plan to increase up to 400 watt hours per kilogram in the next years. Just as a comparison, the current energy density of Panasonic's 2170 cells, for example used in the Model 3 and Model Y, is 246 watt-hours per kilogram. So this would mean at least a 22% increase in energy density. But of course, at the same time, the cost of manufacturing will be severely decreased by this fabrication process. We're talking about $100 per kilowatt hour, 1 million mile batteries with up to 350 watt hours per kilogram of energy density here. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is a total game changer.
We believe that the first car, which will spark this new battery, will be the Model S Plaid, which has been visualized by Alvin Art in this awesome render here. We hope the new Model S will look like this. Realistically, the Model S Plaid will probably have a 500-mile range, since the current generation Model S already has a range of 400 miles. This is so insanely far ahead of anything legacy carmakers have to offer. While most legacy automakers are struggling to stay afloat during the crisis and will bring out new electric cars with far less range in the next 1 to 2 years, Tesla will just further increase their lead. This means that no one in their right mind will buy non-Tesla electric cars. Even more so, since the Tesla cars will soon be self-driving. We estimate that in 2, maximum 3 years, a Tesla car can earn you $30,000 per year as part of Tesla's robotaxi network. Oh yeah, and Tesla also has their giant, ever-expanding supercharger network on top. But as if that wasn't enough, current estimates show that Tesla might be able to sell 800,000 cars in 2021. That's right, 800,000. Giga Nevada and Fremont will together reach a combined capacity of 54 megawatt hours annually later this year. And next year, we will have Model Y deliveries starting in China, Model Y production starting at Giga Berlin, and also the new Central US terafactory. And this is just bound to continue. And according to our projections, they will be selling 1.2 million cars in 2022 and 2 million cars by 2024.
And this is when legacy car makers will really start coming out with their own electric cars in earnest. But this will of course be far too late. Tesla will be so far ahead by that time that they will realize their own Nokia moment has arrived. The only ones that will stand a chance will be innovative startups like Lucid, who have compelling products such as the Lucid Air with a high enough range that will not be too far behind Tesla, or Rivian, who will have an electric pickup truck that might be compelling for some people due to its more conservative styling. And VW might also survive because they invest massively in building EV factories all over the place. But for many others like Toyota or GM, it might be too late. Okay, they might not completely go bankrupt because we know that Nokia still exists, but they will certainly exist as smaller car makers in a much more diminished form, who will produce inferior electric cars, which will only be bought by a small percentage of the population. That will be the fate of many legacy car makers. But apparently some pretend that this isn't the case, because we all know that the truth hurts, right? And apparently the Audi CEO Markus Duesmann really cannot bear the truth. It hurts too much. So what does he say? He stated recently that, quote, Tesla is not ahead in lithium-ion battery tech. And as if that wasn't comical enough, he added that Audi is catching up. Wait, so Tesla is not ahead, but Audi is catching up? How exactly does that work? How can you catch up to someone who is not ahead? Anyways, this guy is apparently really good at denying reality. It's a really good skill if you want to live in your own little bubble fantasy world. You know, many Hollywood celebrities also suffer from this syndrome.
Anyways, now finally some news on the current status of all the gigafactories. Last week, we already mentioned the extremely fast building progress at Giga Berlin. And it is still continuing, with many more new pillars rising. And if this continues, we can expect the roof construction start at Giga Berlin by August. It's always good to compare it to Giga Shanghai's progress to see where we are currently standing. We also mentioned that according to new reports, Giga Berlin will be scaled down now. Now some people told us this was fake news, so we took a look at Tesla's most recent filing documents for Giga Berlin. And it appears that Giga Berlin is still headed for 500,000 cars per year. However, the original document also says that at the beginning, only 100,000 cars will be built per year at Giga Berlin. It could thus be that the factory will first remain at 100,000 cars per year until at some point in the future it will be expanded. So it is not entirely clear yet what Tesla is planning, and the full factory expansion will still happen as it looks. Meanwhile, at Giga Shanghai, The Model Y expansion looks almost finished now. Giga Shanghai will be at a production capacity of 250,000 cars per year by the end of 2020. So this year, together with the 500,000 cars from Giga Nevada and Fremont, then maybe 50,000 cars from Giga Berlin, and maybe even 50,000 cars from Giga Austin, leads to our 850,000 upper estimate for Tesla sales in 2021.
Oh, and speaking of Austin and Tulsa, now I'm pronouncing it correctly again. Last time this was a mistake. We have the sad news, dear viewers, that it appears more and more that Austin is winning the race for the central US Giga or Terafactory. Because according to Electrek, Tesla has secured an important approval for a tax break from a local school district to build its next Gigafactory near Austin, Texas. Electrek thinks that it is very likely that Tesla will soon announce Austin the winner for the factory location, and we have to agree, this sounds highly probable. But then of course, is Tulsa doomed? Tulsa Doom is really angry about this decision, it appears, and now we understand why he was so evil in Conan the Barbarian. But don't worry, Tulsa is not doomed, since we think that if Tesla chooses to build another facility, it will be in Tulsa. Because the amount of compassion and the effort Tulsa put in to get Tesla were just far too good to be left unrewarded. In other highly exciting news, Elon indicated that we might get an update on Neuralink on the 28th of August. And he also updated the Neuralink mission statement on Twitter. He said, "If you can't beat them, join them." What? Now what would he mean by that? Join who? Well, many think that the emergence of a superintelligence in form of a self-aware AI will be a possible humanity extinction event. In order to prevent the AI from getting rid of us inferior fleshies, with Neuralink we would merge with the AI. Thus, humanity would become a part of this AI overlord, and it would then cut off its own arm by getting rid of humanity. That is basically the idea. Neuralink seeks nothing less than preventing such a scenario, which we've been warned about in countless sci-fi movies. We think there will be some highly exciting updates, and we can't wait until the 28th of August.
And we also have some good news on Hyperloop. Virgin Hyperloop announced its inclusion in a Future of Transportation Act that just passed the US House of Representatives. The so-called Move Forward Act, if passed by the Senate, would assign the non-traditional and emerging transportation technology council to provide guidance and a regulatory framework over the next 6 months to get the Hyperloop finally off the ground. In the Hyperloop section of this massive 2,000-page document, the act lays out that the council will work together with the Hyperloop team to establish a regulatory framework that encompasses safety, oversight, environmental impact, and project delivery. This is big news, actually, since receiving regulation through the United States Department of Transportation can be seen as an important validation of the Hyperloop technology and the proof that it isn't just a pipe dream, as some people would have wanted us to believe.
And if you're new to this channel and believe all the lies against Hyperloop spread by some certain people, we recommend you to watch this video here.
So thanks for watching the JS Disruption Report. And I'd say, on to the future. Louisville.
Louisville.
There's no I.
Louisville. I don't know, we're pronouncing it wrong again anyway.